Quickly to the air is Wilson. This pass out wide to Hall. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 12 yards on the gain. A great start for this offense.
Well, partner, that's the start that you want right there. And you know he spent the entire offseason throwing hundreds, I'd probably say thousands of passes, getting ready for that moment. The first throw of the new season. He's dreamed about it, thought about it, and now it's out of the way.
Yeah, one for one, a lot more to go. First carry for the Iowa State man, Breece Hall. And he's going to bowl his way forward to the 48. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
The last run got six, now second and four. Throwing is Wilson. It's caught by Davis. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. Wilson on the hook up to Davis. First down, Jets. First and 10, it's Hall. Down to the 42, second down.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. Wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Here's Wilson. That's caught by his tight end, Uzama. And he's going to be taken down just shy of the 35.
Let's not quibble about the gain there on second down. That was a positive play because that was a take-what-you-can-get situation. Got out to the tight end. Now gives him a much better opportunity to convert on third down.
Third and inches, and they've got some extra beef up front. Three tight ends. They'll run with Hall. And he gets it to the 32. Good enough for a first down. Just 4 yards on the pickup, but that's good enough to extend the drive.
Well, partner, what do you think? Might have been four down territory if they didn't pick it up, but...
Yeah, it's a moot point now. I was curious, so if they didn't get it there, would they have gone for it? I guess we'll never know.
Yeah, we didn't have to make that call, but I have a feeling both of us would have said, go for it.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. This time, Wilson will throw. Open man, and he fumbled it. It's on the ground, and this is picked up by the Dolphins. The big fella, 20, 10, and they will finally put it into the return, but not until he takes it back all the way inside the 10-yard line. So the turnover forced and a wonderful job on a big return.
And how about the convoy that got created to help him get all the way back upfield? I mean, that's the part that people miss on. That's practice. That's worked on. It doesn't just happen in a game and everyone rallies. They discuss it prior to, and everyone knows their role when they create a turnover like that.
Mayfield now after the fumble recovery. Intercepted. Picked up by Jordan Whitehair. And the Jets are going to take over once again, and they'll have it at their own 8-yard line. CD, when he went to throw that, I'm not sure if he just didn't see where the defense was. Whatever the case, not the throw you're looking for on first and goal.
Not at all, because, look, let's face it, that close to the goal line, if you throw an interception, it's going to hurt on any down. But really, the only down you can kind of live with is if you do it on fourth down. The first three, if you don't have it wide open, just get rid of it. Make sure they can't get it and live to fight another down. First and goal, and you throw the pick, not good at all.
After the loss to start out, here's second and 11. Ball again on second down.
And he's up past the 10 to about the 12. 5 yards on the carry there, and it leaves him with third and about 6 yards to go.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
And they'll get to him short of the first down at about the 16. The result, only 4 yards there on the play. And it'll be fourth down.
Now the Jets send on Braden Mann to punt.
Back deep is Tyreek Hill. And taken right on the 30. 49-yard punt, 5 on the return. And it'll be Dolphin football. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive.
And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back, but make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
First down, Mayfield. Going up top.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And the Jets are going to take possession here at their own 47-yard line.
Well, it doesn't take a whole lot of investigation to figure out why they're still sitting at zero on the scoreboard, because their quarterback's got to wake up and start reading defense a heck of a lot better after throwing the second interception.
Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. They start near midfield following the interception as they begin first and 10. And the reinforcements come in as they're going to stop him behind the line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
The running lanes have definitely not been there for him here in the first half, and I don't think it's all been his fault. His offensive line hasn't given him much space. A loss results there.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
I know at times people think we use it too often, but you've got to be able to throw guys open. And when you read zone, you've got to stick it in there before your receiver gets to the next guy in the zone. Otherwise, you bring him into the play.
And that's precisely what allowed that defense to disrupt the pass. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Here's Wilson. And he fires one, but incomplete. So it doesn't look like they're going to be able to build off the turnover.
Well, the defense certainly did its part. It got them the football. But you're exactly right. It looks like they're going to have to punt this one away. And it's not a turnover, but doesn't it feel like one after grabbing the momentum with the defensive play?
Yeah, and they had all that momentum after getting the football, and now zapped right back in the other direction.
Well, someone's going to be happy with that effort. You know who else is going to be happy? His defense.
Absolutely.
He's created a very long field for that offense to try to traverse.
And he got some help from Mr. Football there, checking up nicely. Good English on that punt. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And it's been a miserable start for them offensively, obviously. Two drives, two interceptions.
And this is where you have to know your quarterback and know how you actually have to reach him. Do you do it with a little bit of humor? Maybe you break the ice a little bit, like, hey, didn't we practice in that color jersey all week, not the one that you're throwing it to? Or maybe you have to be stern with him. But whatever it's going to take to get the message, it has to be done. He's putting the game in jeopardy.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and eight. Now Mayfield. That's caught by his big tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he's taken down, but not before he gets this across the 25-yard line. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains. Inside the 30. No score after one on EA Sports. So now then, the big play has him all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. A run with Mostert up the middle.
Brandon, that's what you call being manhandled at the point of attack. And I know the offensive line gets a lot of blame for that one. But occasionally, the defense just knows what you're going to do. Maybe they scouted it perfectly. Maybe someone tipped it off. But on that play, it had no chance.
Looking at a second and 11 now after the loss. To throw, Mayfield. This will be caught. It's Waddle. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the five all the way to the three. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here, and now they're set up with a first and goal.
A chance for their first points of the season here as it's first and goal. Mostert is into the end zone. Touchdown, Miami. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just stay right there, and each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The New York offense taking over for their next possession. And Charles, nothing like squaring off with a division opponent, a division rival in week one. Do you like that they are? And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And the Dolphins are going to take possession of the football. Well, Charles, you got a quarterback out of the pocket trying to make a play, and you get it. But instead, he ends up throwing it to the other team.
And partners, we know to be successful in this league, number one, you're going to have to be able to make plays on the perimeter or when the pocket breaks down. But number two, you've got to make smart decisions with the football. And that time, that simply was not a smart decision.
Following the interception, Mayfield. And he's got his tight end. It's Mike Gesicki. And they're going to get this down inside the 20.
And that was good protection there. No, that was great protection there because it allowed him to lock in on his receiver. Although I think he was looking for his tight end on the corner route all the way. Nice connection there for a really nice game.
On first and 10, it's Mostert. And he stopped immediately there. Credit the tackle to John Franklin Myers. Really good stop there by the end in this 4-3 defense.
And not just pass rushers anymore, are they? Those guys can use their hands, control the point of attack, shed those blockers, and go get those ball carriers.
Mayfield now. Escaping the press. And he can't find anywhere to go with it. And it goes down. Finishing off the corner blitz. How about that? The defense's first sack. It doesn't come from one of the usual suspects up front. It comes from the secondary.
Yeah, I think they caught the quarterback off guard a little bit because he wasn't able to account for the possibility of that blitz and change the blocking assignments. He comes through and puts him on the ground.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Oh, that's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
The kick by Sanders is good. And the Dolphins will add on to their lead. So they get the turnover in plus territory. The drive stalls out, but still able to get three out of that.
Yeah, we were able to see an offense and a defense kind of mix and match with each other, didn't we? Both of them trying to make sure that they have the upper hand and the advantage. Offense trying to get to the end zone. Defense, of course, trying to hold them to a field goal attempt. And it wasn't a guaranteed lock three from where they started. So, you know, the offense has to be happy to come away with those 3 points.
The New York offense taking over for their next possession. This offense returning out there, and really, you remember the last drive, Charles, it was over before it even began. They threw the interception on the very first play.
And what that means is for all these guys, it's been a while since they've been out there going full speed, so they've got to get everyone back out there, run a couple of your go-to plays, make sure you get your offense oiled up a little bit. They've got to be able to start fast, but they've got to be efficient as well.
Especially the quarterback. Now left side on the swing pass. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. So 5 yards here, five on the play. And now third down and six to go.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short game.
The Jets on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This will be third and six. On third down, here's Hall. And he is going to lose yardage here.
We think, Brandon, I like the intensity this defense is showing right here in these first few drives. They're not just holding the line because they're doing their job. But they're doing more than that, aren't they? They're getting a nice push into the offensive backfield.
And a great example right there for the loss on the tackle. On is the punter man as he boots this one away. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. A nice return that time of about 14 yards. And it will be first and 10 as they take over. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And they're not going to play this conservative, I don't think. They had a field goal last time, and they're up, but they're looking to put a drive in the end zone.
Oh, I agree with you totally. No one goes out on the field and says, all right, let's just settle for threes after certain situations. Just ace a game, that sort of deal. Most of the time, it's end zone, and that's what you're thinking, and I believe that's exactly what they're thinking as they begin this one.
Yeah, no quarterback ever goes out there saying, hey, let's get three, right?
Not one that I've ever met.
after the sack. It's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. Working out of the gun, Mayfield. He'll get this into the hands of Mostert. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first?
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play that picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Running the counter with Mostert. And not a lot of daylight, not really any daylight inside, as he's going to be stopped right at the line of scrimmage. Brings up second down. This defense could use a few more plays like that right now.
It certainly could, but think about it from an offense's perspective right now. They've got a lead, but they don't want to throttle down too much and stall themselves. Still want to move at a nice pace.
Throwing on second down. Mayfield. Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. And that is caught. Touchdown, Miami. Jalen Waddle, 31 yards. And the Dolphins are looking good here in the season opener as they're able to extend their lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And that makes our score 17-0. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Offense taking over for their next possession. And we don't want to call this desperation time, especially in the second quarter, but you're down.
You don't want to.
No, but let me finish.
Okay, my bad.
You're down three scores already. You've done nothing offensively, nothing on the scoreboard. That's not a good combination.
I think you just called it. I think you just called it desperation time.
I think you did.
But let's face it. You mentioned this to me in a break earlier in the game. The energy level hasn't been there right from the start. We've noticed that. They've got to find a way to get on their toes and start punching instead of retreating, to use a boxing analogy.
They find some open field here, and they work this well upfield across the 45. First down, Wilson. There's Hall bringing in another one. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. That'll go for a gain of 7, and it'll be second down.
It appears they found something that's working, and they keep going back to it. I guess you could actually say he has the hot hands now, doesn't he?
Yeah, well, it's one thing to hit your guy out of the backfield once, hit him a couple times. Yeah, you're right. Maybe they're onto something.
And I think a lot of that is simply, if you get it to him in space, more times than not, he's going to get more yardage than you expect out of each play.
Now the Jets going to use the second of their 3 timeouts. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. Dolphins bring on an extra defensive back on third down. Out of the gun, here's Wilson. And he's got a man, Corey Davis. And he's got this down a yard or two shy of the 40 before he's out of bounds. That's good for 9 yards as they convert on the third down play.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
On first and 10, it's Wilson. To the right side, and he's got more complete. A gain of 8 there on the play. And that'll bring up a second down in just a couple. Wilson. and he fires one incomplete.
They're putting together a drive here in the final minutes of the half, but the coverage has been tight all game long, and they certainly want to keep them off the scoreboard here.
They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. They go play action now. Wilson. Got an open man. That's C.J. Uzama. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins' 13-yard line. They'll give to Hall. And this play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back to the 15. The Jets going to go ahead and use their final timeout as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Step on that last play because the drive has been strong, but now it's 2nd and 12. Throwing is Wilson. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Hall. And down inside the 10 here before he's out of bounds right around the 7. So 8 yards on the completion there, and now it's 3rd and 3. Coming up here, looking for 3 yards to pick up the first. They snap it at 1. Now Wilson. And a big loss here as he's taken down. So we reach halftime here at our first Monday Nighter of the season. As we'll send you down the coast now to Orlando, that's where we find Jonathan Coachman, ready with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. We welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number 3 here. We'll see if week 1 fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. And he will not bring it out. It's a touchback. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And Charles, they got the lead. I would imagine the overall halftime tone was a positive one, but what do you think the talking points were in the locker room?
Well, if there were 3 talking points at the half, partner, all of them were about turnovers because they were pretty loose with the ball. Otherwise, this lead could be even bigger. Now, I don't think that they overly harped on it, but I think they told them, guys, if you want to keep calling those plays that are exciting, you've got to take care of the ball. Otherwise, we may have to dial things back a little bit.
Here we go on 2nd and 12. Got a man complete to Cedric Wilson. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A gain of 28 yards there and give him a first down.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a 3-score lead here in the 3rd quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
And this time they were ready for him as they'll stop him right at the line of scrimmage.
And plays like that are exactly what this defense needs here early in the second half to give it a little spark. I think their halftime adjustments, what they talked about, maybe it was just a little inspirational speech. Who knows? But looks like they're ready to go.
Now they contend with a second and 12 after the loss. Back to throw here. And Wilson with it, complete. And he'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. The catch and run pays off to the tune of 35 yards.
I don't care what level of football you play, this one was a universal, wasn't it? When we were kids and we played touch football, remember we'd get in these positions and you just say, everybody go long and hope someone would come free.
So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Gets it to Hill. It's a jet sweep. It's a 6-yard pickup, and it gets him to second and 4.
That play wasn't quite as big as the play that preceded it, but still, gotta like the way they're moving the football, partner.
Absolutely. Pretty good room to run on that last play.
Yeah, they didn't get a first down, but still, you'll take runs like that each and every time, won't you?
Second down at 4. They'll look to throw. And he's got his big wide receiver complete. Touchdown, Dolphins. Cedric Wilson, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Dolphins take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Oh, this is blocked. And the Jets have got it. Taking it right down Broadway. The 40, the 30, 10, and he takes it the distance across the goal line for 2 points. That is a play that you just do not see very often, maybe a couple times a year, the blocked extra point return for 2.
You can't afford to give anyone a free run at the kicker. Oftentimes, it's going to bounce off his hands or chest and head the other direction.
The lane opens here. He's past the 30. And he is out of bounds as they'll start up past the 30. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. They'll start on the ground, Hall. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Now off the bootleg. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked up by Noah Igbinoghene, and the Dolphins are going to take over at their own 41. Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores, but yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And look, we're still in the third quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder about is the team that just threw that interception, they've got to be careful about developing a sense of complacency and thinking this game is over.
Tackle on that play by Quinnen Williams.
Ladies and gentlemen, that is a force of nature at the defensive tackle position. Yes, he's as big as they come, but still plenty agile. He's able to make a nice play there to swallow up the ball carrier.
Second and 10, third quarter of the season opener. From the shotgun now, here's an inside give. And he'll be brought down, losing yardage back at the 40. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time, because let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
The Jets will bring in a nickel set here as they try to stop this third down. They'll drop to throw. Oh, looking for Waddle, but it's intercepted. picked off by DJ Reed. And the Jets are going to take possession here at their own 33. He had the good earlier, throwing his first career touchdown pass. Now the bad, his first career interception.
So you had to have some balance at some point, right? Isn't that what we all seek in our lives? But here's the thing. He had the success, you mentioned it, through the touchdown pass. Sometimes you press it a little bit more, try a few other things, but that's how you learn. He'll throw a few more interceptions along the way, but I bet he'll balance that with a heck of a lot more touchdown passes, too.
The drive starting with a first down, 11 yards on that pickup.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. This one caught by Davis. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. Usually see those guys out wide get called for holding on running plays. Here, a passing play.
Yeah, sometimes when you get this quick screen, bubble screen, anything where they're having to block for their fellow receiver, usually at the point of attack, and this time he got caught.
Straight ahead is Hall, and he's across the 45. It'll be second down.
You know that old expression, it's not my night? It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
And every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Throwing on second and eight. Wilson, open man is Uzama. And he's got another first down as he's brought down at the Dolphins 33. A gain there of 21 yards.
Well, we talk all the time about playing situational football. Right now, I think the scoreboard is dictating what they need to do. Where they are in this game, they've got to push the ball downfield, take their shots, try and get big chunks of yardage in a short amount of time. That was a nice play there.
That's caught by his tight end, Uzama. And they're going to move it down the inside to 25.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you got to do, you got to kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end. Take some easier completions.
Okay, interception last drive. There he hits the reliable target. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. 4 yards the pickup. First down.
Second and one, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there, pick up the first down.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. He dumps this one off here to Hall. So that'll be no better than an incompletion, and it's second down.
Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. On second down, a run to Hall. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2 yard gain.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
On third down, Wilson. Throwing middle, and it's complete. And I don't think he got there, no. He's short by maybe a foot, maybe. Call it fourth and inches. One quarter remains here as we wrap up the week on a Monday night. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. They'll go for it. It's Hall. And he will have the first down inside the 10 to the 9-yard line. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. There wasn't even thought of a short field goal. There was no hesitation. They were going for it.
I think he was thinking ahead a couple plays ago that if he got in this situation, they were definitely going for it. And you're right. It was a confident call and a decisive run to pick it up.
And the second wave of tacklers is going to get him as they stop him behind the line. It's a loss of a yard there, and it's second down.
There's no question that coming into this game, this defense is pretty vocal about his desire to take this running back out of his game. And all that pregame whooping has turned into results.
Second down and goal. Wilson, he gets it underneath to Hall, and he's able to get it down to the 2 yard line. That catch good for 8, but still, it's third and goal now.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They've become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
This likely a must-have, third and goal. They'll look to run with Hall, and he's in. Touchdown, Jets. Brees Hall taking it in from 2 yards out, and the Jets are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter. So a little bit of a letdown there defensively. I mean, look, you're still 2 scores to the good, CD, but things may be a little more uncomfortable than they had hoped.
Yeah, if you kept them out of the end zone there, this game's over. You locked the door on them. Instead, it's still open a little bit, and they've got a puncher's chance.
And he got it on the touchdown run, but he won't get in here. He'll be stopped short, and they'll come up empty on the try for 2. So a sensational return there on special teams, a foot race that he was not going to lose. Now, meanwhile, while that was going on, we've got an injured player on the field. While the medical staff checks on him, we'll step aside in this week one contest. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. Well, don't look now, but they've got a little bit of a battle on their hands again. Back to a 2-score game, the interception that led to a touchdown. You'd have to think they're a little more careful here if they do indeed try to throw the football.
Yeah, and I was a little surprised by the last throw. You know, that type of throw in this type of a game, I'm going to be very careful about it. Maybe the only throw you make is maybe a toss to your halfback or something like that. Otherwise, take care of the thing and finish this bad boy off.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. On play action, they'll throw. And this one almost intercepted. Far too loose with the football. Nearly a 4th pick of the ball game.
I think he's taking an awful chance with the football right there. You've got a lead, you've got to protect it, and he's taking chances putting it out there in a little bit of jeopardy.
Especially in a spot like this, 4th quarter, as you said, trying to cling to that advantage.
Yeah, that one probably should have been picked, huh?
So the failure to connect on 2nd down, that leaves him staring up here at a 3rd and 8. Mayfield looks to throw. And intercepted. Maybe the turning point they need. Sauce Gardner picks it off. And the Jets are right back in this football game. That is the play they needed in a 2-score game here in the 4th quarter.
No doubt about it. They did what they had to do to give themselves a chance to get back into the game. They turned it over to the offense. They are now in charge.
Now they need to execute. Throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
When you're leading in the final quarter, your radar has to be up for any potential deep shots. And probably not the last one they're going to see in this game, not as long as they hold this lead.
To throw on 2nd and 10. Wilson, and he'll find Hall. And they're going to get this up to midfield.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple scores. They've really got to get some yards in chunks, and they know the defense doesn't want to give those up. They've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together? From midfield now, here's Wilson. He'll find Smith-Schuster. That's complete. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackling.
tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and lead the game out that way.
He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. 25 yards there on the catch and run.
Good yardage on the completion there. When they look at the scoreboard, they do understand the football is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score, because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun, then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
This will be caught inside the 10. And the Jets are going to be set up with a first and goal coming up as they get him down at the 6-yard line.
Correct me if I'm wrong, you know, you're down two scores. I don't think you need to rush just yet, but you can't take your time either.
Yeah, even if you don't want to commit to full two-minute offense, you have to up the tempo, up the urgency. Maybe you're starting to call two plays in a huddle each time you snap the ball.
Toward the pylon, caught. Nice job defensively to hold him to four, and now it's second and goal. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
Two of their three red zone trips so far, they've come up empty on. They'll look to reverse that trend on second and goal. They go play action with Wilson. And this will be caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Jets. Tyler Conklin from a yard out. And the Jets get a bit closer. So this now a 9-point difference. You figure the book here says kick the extra point, make it a one-score game.
Now, you and I have seen coaches get overly aggressive in this spot, but I agree with you. Kick it here and get back within a score.
The offense knew it. They were already starting to walk back as that one is accepted. And now in a 9-point game, they'll still just need to go for one here. It's good, so that will get back with a big score. Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. From the 10. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. Ready. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. I'm curious to see, Charles, about the play calling on this drive. Last time out, the interception that led to a touchdown. Here we are. I mean, it's very close. One score game.
Yeah, and if I'm a defender, I'm actually chirping Chili on the other side of the ball, saying, hey, we picked off the last one. What you going to do about it now? So when you do throw the football, high percentage, but throw it with confidence. Because if there's any hesitancy at all, it could end up in enemy's hands again.
Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. They've got a first and 10 as they look to try and finish this one off.
Ready, set.
Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. Now back to throw. And this one too low.
See, I'm not quite sure how to judge that one. Maybe he didn't have enough legs underneath him. Mechanics might have been off. Maybe some fatigue. That one came up short.
Yeah, fourth quarter. Maybe you do start to watch. Is the arm there? The leg's still there. This has been a tough game. So second down, still 10 yards to go. Ball on the 43. Well, the lead late in the fourth, but Mayfield's going to throw it. And going deep for Hill. That's caught inside the 20. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Tyreek Hill, 57 yards. And the Dolphins are closing in on a winning start to the year as they extend their fourth quarter lead. Sanders on for the extra point. And the lead is up to 15 now. Morstead out now following the touchdown to kick. Jets offense coming up now to start their next drive. The long drive last time out for this offense, Charles, if you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
And partner, as a former defensive back, I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now, but let's give credit where it's due because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
Yeah, because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football. On second and 10, Wilson. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Back-to-back incompletions, but we know this is definitely four down territory. Time not on their side. I don't think they want to try and get the first down in two installments. I think they got to go and get it right here, right now.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has them staring at a third and 10. From the gun, it's Wilson. Open man here is Conklin. And he is going to have a Jets first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Now a timeout called for by the offense as they'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the first down. Here's Wilson to throw. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
Limited time left on the clock after that incompletion, so I think both sides are going to savor every second to prepare before the next snap. Because once the ball's in motion, it may be a nonstop push to finish this drive off. Everyone better be on the same page right now, because I think they're going to try and get several plays off in quick succession if they can.
Wilson will throw again. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Give it big credit for his coverage right there because when he saw the route break deep, he stayed in position to prevent a completion while avoiding any risk of a flag.
An incomplete pass on second down. It muddles things a little bit here. This is third and 10. Hall on a give up the middle. And he'll only get this to the 47. He needed a few more yards to pick up the first. Now the Jets going to use the second of their three timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here we go. It's Wilson on fourth down. That's to his running back complete. And now this is going to be close.
The defense says they stopped him, and they did. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And defensively, that might just seal a Week 1 victory. And the Jets D, they call on a couple extra defensive backs on third. Partner, that'll do it. These Week 1 primetime games, they always seem to have a little bit more electricity, a little more anticipation, a fun one tonight, and a lot of fun ones that we have on the road ahead.
And partner, I love the word you just used there, electricity. Things were crackling out there, weren't they? And let's face it, both of these teams came in with the idea, get off to the start. Get off to a 1-0 start and get your season going. That could spark an excellent season for them. They've got that in their pocket now.
So for the Dolphins, it'll be a happy trip home as they start the season with a road victory here on a Monday night. And they'll return home next week to take on the New England Patriots. Meanwhile, for the Jets, they obviously fall to 0-1 with the defeat.
The chauffeur to open Mercedes door, put the pedal to metal and made it soar. She was, but I made it sure it was, so we stayed indoors. Let's take it where no one has been before. It feel like I've known you some years before, but I don't know. Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more. She's a Lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply braggadocious, why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you are, we own it. Like a mic. I've got a no sleep. I remember when it was the no sleeves. Now they captured the fashion from flow seeds. I'm a whole king.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a Lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply braggadocious. Why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you are, we own it. Ooh, it's trouble in paradise. So let's parachute where the air's nice. And let's risk it all on the paradise. But she just wanna make sure her hair's nice. That's fair, right? I just fell in love with a prima donna. The 2023 Madonna. I mean, your honor. I was minding my business until she gave me complete nirvana.
Are you ready? Okay, say no more. Are you ready? Okay, say no more.
She's a Lotus and I'm the conductor of a magnum opus. Simply braggadocious. Why don't we take advantage of this moment? And wherever you are, we are.
Nobody really cares.
in heaven. I love when you toss me blessings. You never throw interceptions. I catch them like Odie Beckham. Hard to not the devil when built like Tiana Taylor. And balling at 27, I feel like he must.